2nd of April 2017 and we're back again doing another epic ride. Well, we're at John O Groats and I said that I'd come back and do this ride again, but today we're going to start the ride, a 9-day plan from the north of the United Kingdom, John O Groats, to the south of the United Kingdom, Land's End. As you can see, it says 874 miles to Land's End. We might end up doing about 920. The weather looks okay. It might rain a bit, it might be sunny, that's typical. So come on, let's go and do a ride. Right, let's get going. So today's stage is from John O Groats and we're going to go to Invergordon. It should be around 98 miles. And I have been told it's downhill all the way, but it's not quite downhill all the way. Just passed through a village called Keith. The wind's coming this way at me. It's a cross, slightly head wind. And that wind, it just takes the edge off the pace. We're 17 miles into the ride and we're just going through Wick. And the sun's coming out. This is civilization. Just going through Thrumster. There'll be an interesting section way ahead with some big climbs, big descents. Big descent now and our first big climb coming up. There's the road ahead. Get the camera away now, it's been pretty fast down here. That was a wicked descent with some good hairpin bends on it. That was brilliant. I'm out of breath now going down there and I've got a big climb up here, the Berrydale Braes. Right, just stopped for a bite to eat. Caithness, that side, John O Groats, and Helmsdale's over there. We're on a high point here. Good descent here now, all the way down to Brora and Golspie, and following the coast across to there, towards Invergordon in the end. We've just dropped down into Helmsdale, off the big hills there, right at sea level now. Nice blue skies. The air's a bit fresh. It's about 10 degrees, but that's okay. Right, we're 60 miles into the ride. Helmsdale's that way, Brora's this way, and Golspie. There's a plaque here, and what it says is that this marks the place where the last wolf in Sutherland was killed, according to scopes out of deer stalking, by the hunter Paulson in or about the year 1700. So there you go. Windy, but all right, it's hard going though. Not far to go, about 15 mile now. I'm at Invergordon, there's a nice ship in the bay. We're a 99 mile ride with a constant headwind all day, so there were no hiding, no resting. And we spent 6 hours and 50 minutes in the saddle. It was wet and cold at the start for the first 20 mile, but after that it's got really good weather now, so it's nice. Stayed overnight at the Tucker's Inn, great food, and I would stay there. Today's route will be around 93 miles, heading towards Loch Ness, and then over to Fort William. It may rain later on. I can see snow on the mountains as well from here. So let's go and do a ride. A9 then was quite dangerous and busy with big wagons. We're just cycling through Dingwall past the station there. Alright, we're going to turn right now on the 683 to Drumnadrock, I think, and that'll drop me in towards Loch Ness. It's a cracking route this. Gorgeous round here, gorgeous. Still got that headwind, it's not blowing a gale, but it's just making it hard work. I'm on quite a long straight climb here out of Kiltarty Lodge. There's no point fighting it, I'll just get it in the nice easy gear. This climb's on a hill and a place called Arden Drain. Just got to the top of this climb at Arden Drain, and you can't help but notice this, which reminds you are on the right route. There's many routes, they all lead to the same place, but here we are, Land's End, 732 miles to go. We've got a big climb ahead here. Drop down here. There's a climb up there. Woo! An absolute wicked descent down the Oakbank Road. Really fast and windy. Brilliant. The headwind's taking it out of my speed. I'm doing 9 miles an hour. 13 if I'm lucky. Well, we're doing about 21 now. I'm beginning to ask myself, does this bloody lock ever end? It's been going on for some while now. There we go, give you some of the view. Fantastic. Just leaving Fort Augustus behind us. On the road to Fort William now. Well, we've got rain. It's hard work. Look at this ahead, a big glacial valley, and it's grey, dark, snow on the tops up there on the right. Bring it on, Fort William, 20 miles to go. We're just going past the Commando Memorial there. We've got Speen Bridge ahead of us, and then Fort William. It's a nice descent all the way down. And there's Ben Nevis ahead, in the mist. It's all murky there today. No view, sadly. Soaking wet, look at the state of this. Absolutely dripping, soaking wet. The main thing is I'm warm. Warm fingers, warm toes. It is that rain that gets you wet here in Fort William. That were a hard 90 mile ride with tough winds and over 5,500 foot of climbing. I think in the end I was averaging on there 14 miles per hour, but for a long time it was 12. Just no speed at all today. It's day 3 of JOGLE. I'm in Fort William, next to Loch Linney. It's windy again, headwind coming right at me. So I thought I'd wear anyway today my King of the Mountains, because we're in the mountains today. So today's ride will be about 100 miles into Glasgow, right down the A82 through Loch Lomond area. That'll be nice. Looking ahead down there, Loch Linney there, it looks like it's going to throw it down again. Just have a look at this here. Let's go and do a ride. Okay, we're underway. I've got my 2,000 calorie Scottish breakfast inside me. That'll keep me going. Loch Linney there. It's fresh. It's pretty cold. It's all part of the fun. I'm on the approaches now to Glencoe. Looks amazing. You've got to get this on your bucket list. Oh yeah. Is about 22 miles away, and at this pace that'll be about an hour, but I'm not a pro cyclist, so it could change. 29 miles an hour, there's the valley, there's the road. This should be brilliant. 30 miles an hour. We're on the plateau now. Tindrum's about 16, 17 miles away. It's time to say goodbye to that fantastic scenery. Right, I've just stopped just to take in that last view. I can't just keep pedaling and pedaling, I've got to stop at some point. It's good, isn't it? It's great. Let's just drop down the A82 now and get onto Loch Lomond. Just leaving Argyll and Bute, now into Stirling. Just on the outside of Ardlewy now, and I've got Loch Lomond just on my left there. I'm just cycling over the Erskine Bridge. Oh my God, this is high up. Oh, don't look down. Oh, this is not good for me at all. Oh, 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 it's high up. Oh, I can't film this. Can't do it. Good ride yesterday. Went from Fort William into Glasgow. Right at the end, it's the A82, it's so busy. Don't like it, it's too much traffic. So I ended up going over the massive Erskine Bridge in the end, which I find pretty scary. I didn't want to go over it, but I ended up going over it. And to boot, I went under the Clyde, under one of them tunnels, so we put a few more miles on the journey to try and find this street, I think it's called Sackyall Street. So it was a good ride in the end, 105 miles, and a good pace, because the wind did actually, in general, help me out. It's Wednesday, the 5th of April. I'm just outside the Kelvin Grove Art Gallery, and it's time to leave Glasgow and head south of the border today, and we're going back over into England to Penrith. The wind should be favourable, it should be like a northeasterly. It should help the ride that today. So let's get out of Glasgow city centre. Let's go and do a ride. Just making our way down one of these main streets. I think it's Argyle Street in Glasgow. So neither wits about me, it's busy. Got to follow the GPS to get down all these lanes and streets and what have yous. It's a nightmare getting round here. You've got to know what you're doing. Blinking heck. It's so busy. We're on the Camberslang Road out of Glasgow and we're going to be heading towards Hamilton. We're in the Larkhall area now and I finally got onto the B7078 and that'll take me a long way south now. Nice cycle lane here with good tarmac. That surface there on the 7078 is pretty rough. It's not got potholes, it's just hard. And it's going pretty quickly. We're about 33 miles from Southwaite near Penrith. Well, I'm just behind this tractor, 27 miles an hour. Been doing this for quite a while, but don't try this at home. Just passing through Gretna Green, 4 hours 45 minutes from Glasgow. If this track is going my way, that'll do. There's Gretna behind. Another great ride there. And yeah, and getting behind that tractor, that really, really helped. I think I followed that tractor in for quite a long way. And once you're out of Glasgow on the B7076, it's fantastic cycling country that. It is actually pretty much downhill all the way. You're going through some fantastic places, great scenery. Into Gretna, over the border, and you've got Carlisle ahead of you. Well, that were a fast ride. It was 5 hours 46 minutes from Glasgow to Southwaite, so that were a good day. And the bike's proper dusty, I'm filthy, no rain, good wind, so that's not a bad day at all, that. Today is the 6th of April 2017. Stayed at the travel lodge just off the motorway, Carlisle, last night, and we've got a tough leg today going back to home, which will take us through the Yorkshire Dales. We'll be going towards Penrith first, then on towards Sedbergh, a place called Kirby Lonsdale. Then we're going to do a cracking little cycling route right through some single track lanes towards Sladeburn, so that'll be really hilly. And then, just to put some more hills into the mix, we're going to cross a cracking little place. It's called the Nick of Pendle. It'll be alighting around Burnley and back home towards Todmorden. So that'll be a very hilly 99.2 mile ride today. And mechanicals, yeah, we've got some bike talk, bit of bike talk going on here. My bottom bracket, albeit Dura Race 9000, on its way out because there's a lot of play in there. Can you hear that rattle? So there's play. I've got two spare bearings at home, just the outer casings. We'll replace them. We get back to the garage tonight. Other than that, the bike's going really well. So let's go and do a ride. Just 10 miles in, going through Penrith town centre. Cycling through a small village hamlet called Clifton, where the last battle on British soil was fought in 1745. We're high up, about 1,000 foot, heading towards Orton. Behind us, we've got the Yorkshire Dales and parts of Lancashire all around us, and we're going a bit quick here, one handed. Hey. Oh yeah, that is fast, 35 mile an hour. Yeah, we're heading towards Higher Bentham. This is Burton in Longsdale, with Kirby Longsdale behind me over there. This section now will be quite tough, it'll be up and down. We're now on the climb to Slade Burn and that area, going through the top of Bowland, or the Bowland Fells. If you look to my left shoulder, you can see Penny Ghent, then in the middle Ingleborough, and just slightly behind on the right is Wernside. And we're pretty remote up here and isolated on the road to Slade Burn. We're still making our way on this single track lane. Them views behind me, they are knockout. You can even see the sea over there. Lake District. That's where we've come from, right over there. The Howgills come right through there. There's a stone right here that's been dumped by the ice. Big rock. All the Yorkshire Dales. It's a great viewpoint, this. Okay, that was a wicked climb for 1,450 foot above sea level. As far as the eye can see, we've done it. This might be the highest point on the trip. The canary head is Stocks Reservoir, just cycling through Slade Burn. Well, it's been a tough day this. We're on one of the final climbs of the day, with Pendle Hill behind me there. We've already climbed over 7,700 feet. Back at HQ, my hometown, my home village, and that was a tough, tough ride. Some cracking roads. So I'm going to get home now, clean the bike, have some real ale, and have a good night's sleep. day 6 of Joggle, and we're 15 miles from home in the centre of Manchester going down Deansgate. It's busy, a bit like Glasgow was, super busy, people everywhere. Going towards Shrewsbury today. It should be about another 100 mile leg, and we're heading towards Nantwich, that area, Altrincham, Nantwich, Whitchurch, and then pick up the Shrewsbury area. Well, I'm following the A556 towards Nantwich, and there's a new road being built, like a motorway, and it's not safe on here. And the old road there's been shut, so I've been told I can't go on it. So I'm going to detour. It's too dangerous on these kind of roads here, just going to kill yourself. Well, we're heading on these lovely Cheshire lanes now, going towards Pickmere, because the route behind me before, I tried several ways to get back onto the original route, but the road's totally gone, disappeared. We're about 70 miles in, we're saying goodbye to Cheshire, and we're now in Shropshire on the A49, heading towards Shrewsbury. To watch this road, it can be a busy road, big wagons. I've had to put some pace on there. I fell way behind because of all them road works earlier. It's gone sunny as well, nice and warm. Just on the outskirts of Shrewsbury, we're about 11 miles from the destination now. It's always a tough finish, this one. Climbing out above Shrewsbury now to Ench Marsh. It's a really small little place, way up in the hills. The views are great up here, it's lovely green countryside, beautiful round here. About 3 miles to go. Just listen to this. Birds singing. April 2017, and it's day 7 of Joggle, and I stayed here last time at Ench Marsh Farm. It's a cracking place, I recommend it. And we're gonna go towards Bristol today, crossing over the border into Wales, heading on towards Monmouth, and then near Chepstow, and I think we're gonna cross the River Severn. Let's go and do a ride. We're on the way to Church Stretton. It's just gorgeous. All I can hear is birds singing, and just lovely green rolling countryside, and whatever's in them fields, that's yellow. Just climbing out of Ludlow there. That's a beautiful little town, that. And I got a bit of a drag down one of the roads there by Ludlow Cycling Club. And boy, they can move. We're in that beautiful county of Herefordshire now. We're about 5 miles from Leominster. This is a gorgeous county. Shropshire, Herefordshire. Can't beat it. We'll be right back. first cut past the football ground there. The road ahead here goes to Abergavenny. We want the Monmouth Road. Just on some big lumpy hills back there. Climbing up to about 600 foot above sea level. Now we're on some nice little downhills. Just going through Monmouth. What a nice little place this is. Okay, I'm on the climb out of Monmouth. It's a big one. There's only one way out of this place, and that's up. And it's a lot warmer today. It's the warmest day so far. Very warm. On my left there, we've got Chepstow Racecourse. And we're about 2.5 miles from the station bridge going over the River Severn. There's the racecourse there. There's a horse race on there, you can see them in the background. I'm on the cycle lane now to Aust, which goes over the bridge. So this could be an experience. I'll show you when we get nearer. There's two routes over this bridge. There's one to Aust, that's the south side. I'm going to go on the north side one. Exactly 675 miles from John O Groats, halfway over the River Severn. We're in Bristol now, it's over another suspension bridge, not far to go. About 6 miles to the digs now. Crossing that bridge means we're now in North Somerset. So we've done quite a list of counties today, and we're now going to go through these grounds. Just have to stop here. We're in Ashton Court. It's called Ashton Court Estate, and all that there will be Bristol. So we're just on the south side of it. So just got to keep moving now. Been in the saddle for about 7 hours. I've been baking in the sun. I'm probably really burnt, but you can't complain. Glencore a few days ago, fantastic. And then he wrapped up, and today, the summer's day. Day basically done. I'm near the airport at Bristol. Signs here: Felton, Winford, Ridge Hill. Had a tough day in the sun. That lots of climbing, lots of ups, lots of downs. Had to be fit to do that one today. That were a tough day. Morning. This is day 8 of Joggle. Just going to leave Felton near the airport at Bristol. Yesterday was a tough ride. I got baked in the sun, just shy of 6,000 foot of climbing. Lots of peaks, about 14 peaks on that ride. We're going to get on the A38 now, and head all the way basically towards Tiverton, and then eventually get to Oakhampton. So I've got some options when I get nearer to Tiverton as to whether I use back lanes or main roads. A38's here now. Okay, we're in Somerset now. Just crossed over the River Ack and it's warming up quite nicely. Just approaching Bridgewater now. It's pretty flat for a long way on here now. We're out in Taunton. It's took us about 2.5 hours to get here. And we're 735 miles from John O Groats. And we're 20 miles from Tiverton. Just passing a cider farm. Look at all the apple trees here. Rows and rows of apple trees. We've got the final two counties to go. Welcome to Devon. Just saying goodbye to Somerset. And we're 10 miles from Tiverton. Well, I stopped here on LEJOG last year. It's getting really warm. Watch, I'm getting burnt here. It's not been a bad ride, that, actually. Lovely spot this though, really, really nice spot. Okay, let's keep moving. We're about 60 miles into the ride at the moment. Yesterday's ride, which was from Felton to Oakhampton, 90 mile on the dot with about 4,500 foot of climbing. Good ride that. But today is the final day of Joggle, final day. We're going to head out of Oakhampton and we're going to go towards Launceston and try and make a route up, avoiding the A30 and going around Bodmin on the north side. It's going to be a tough ride. It's going to be hilly, it's going to be lumpy. It's a bit fresher today, it's not as warm. It's the final day, we've got to make it, and we will. Not quite sure how many miles it'll be today, because I'm going to break it down into stages to try and navigate along some of these little back lanes through Cornwall. But it could be between 100 and 110 miles today. We're still in West Devon, going through Lifton Down on the way to Launceston. We're in Cornwall, the final county. Just going past Launceston Rugby Ground. I've had to get changed and put some more base layers on. It's quite nippy today. We're now on the B3254. We're heading towards Camelford next. Oh, Kikoki, where am I? We're about 4.5 miles from Bodmin on a really small little back road. It's a nice one, this. It's a bit dirty and dusty. Okay, I'm on the Campbell Trail now, about 4 or 5 miles from Bodmin, so it should give me a nice flatter run on a bit of a kind of cindery gravelly track, so hopefully no punctures, but I've not been down here for a long time, but it'll be flat, so that's a bit of fun on the adventure. Still no punctures. We're out of Bodmin now, left Bodmin! And we're on our way to go. next week in Truro. 35 miles to go. Just keep doing it one bit at a time now. Just got to keep picking these little towns off. Some Camborne, Redruth area. Just gone through Hale. Got to tick off Penzance next. And then we're on the home straight. Right, well, we've finally made it. It says 874 on there, and we've got 899, so that's not too bad. And there's one thing I will say, don't give in and do believe in yourself. We've done it. Joggle John O Groats to Land's End. I did that way back in April. It's now January 2018 and it's wild out there, and I'll probably go for a bike ride later on as well. And yeah, I did get some support. My mother and father, they came along. If it's one thing I owe them, it's a massive thank you for all the time and the effort that they put in with me. I know they really enjoyed it, they loved the journey as well, but without them it wasn't really possible. And this is the bike. It's done it again. It never let me down. It's not a racing machine, but it'll go all day, and I've cycled the length and breadth of the country on this. I can't fault it. My memories of the journey. Oh yeah, going over the Erskine Bridge. Whoa, that's not my cup of tea, it's all that. I'm just not really good with bridges. Every day, full of highlights. It was great to meet up with my mate Steve. He lives way up there near John O Groats. He built his own house up there. Cycling through the Pass of Glencoe, absolutely breathtaking, stunning. I can't believe you can cycle through such a beautiful place and it's for free. Yeah, and you do get emotional. It hit me at Truro.
Tears streaming down my face.
And I was fighting it for miles and miles, but it's a massive achievement. It's a real challenge. Fantastic cities, counties, rivers, hills, mountains, you name it. Whatever the weather can throw at you. Red hot days. Soaking wet and freezing cold days. If you've watched this video and you fancy doing John O Groats to Land's End, I hope it's given you some inspiration and an insight into what cycling joggle is all about. For me, it's all about passion, it's commitment and determination. Thank you for watching.